Hello and welcome back to the Advanced Rocketry Tutorial Series. In this video, we will go through the spacesuit and the upgrades for it, and then how to use all of them. We'll actually make a trip to the moon just to demonstrate one thing. But right, so let's get started with the suit station or suit workstation. Simple to craft, and you'll need it to manage your spacesuit. So as you can see here, this is how it looks. Pretty neat, right? And the recipes are quite simple. You will need a few things, for example, a steel fan, liquid fuel tanks. These are items that will be used for lots of other things as well, but you need them for the spacesuit. So the helmet, a bit of glass and mostly iron. And then we have the chest piece. We need leggings, also very simple, and boots. So some iron and lots of wool. So once you have everything, you can have it on you. And well, basically not much is happening. You need to upgrade it and put some additional items in it to make it really functional and be useful, especially when you go up to the moon. But some parts are even useful on the Earth, or well, on all planets that you go to. So let's take a look here. In the workstation here, you can take your helmet. As you can see, I have it on me. And here you put it in the workstation, and here you apply all the upgrades. So in this, well, I actually put a lot of upgrades on this, and I will go through them all in a moment. The chest piece is perhaps the most important one. I recommend using building the jetpack. It's very, very useful at all times. Legs can be useful even on when you're just questing or mining, I don't know, out exploring. Boots as well, especially with the upgrade. So let's go over and I'll just quickly show how to craft all the items, and then I'll demonstrate how to use them. First, here we have the hover upgrade. All these five items are upgrades to the helmet. They are all made in the precision assembler, like the leg, what's it called? The bionic leg upgrade, precision assembler, and the padded boots. So this is only the materials needed, but you make them in the assembler. Let's see, if you look this, and you can see the same items here. So that's what it mean. We have the visor. Let's see, do like this. Beacon finder, anti-fog visor, atmosphere analyzer, and then we have the flight speed control upgrade, and then the hover upgrade that we had first. And you, well, not all are required. This speed control upgrade is totally optional. Even if you have the hover upgrade for your jetpack, then this is optional. It just makes you fly faster. I'll demonstrate that in a while. The atmosphere analyzer is probably good to have. It's not required, but I mean, if you go to other planets other than the moon, it can be quite useful. The anti-fog visor can be useful when you have, if you're on a planet with lots of fog. I don't know if it's useful at other occasions as well, but anyway, it's an upgrade. You can bring it with you in exchange and all of that. All the upgrades can be removed and applied as long as you have the suit workstation. And then finally, the beacon finder, also totally optional, but can be useful if you don't have any map add-ons. So you can put beacons in your up on the moon, for example, and then this will help you find the way back. We'll go up there and demonstrate it. The jetpack is perhaps the most useful item because you can use it on the ground, here on Earth, and up in space. And it's not too bad to craft either. However, it runs on hydrogen, and I will demonstrate how to refill it. And then we have the bionic. I keep right pressing here, but right clicking. We don't need to do that. The bionic leg upgrade is can actually be stacked. If I run like this, I will get quite a nice speed boost, and it doesn't even require power. So this can be useful when exploring, both on Earth and up in the space. And then perhaps this very useful item for everywhere in the universe is the padded landing boots. This, it's an upgrade to the feet, the space boots. And it totally removes the falling damage. And to be able to see all these upgrades, then we need to be in survival mode. So now we're in, this is how it will look for you. As you can see, running is just as fast. But if we go into the, let's see, and place another one in the suit station, we're even faster, and I also think this stacks with the speed, what's it called? The haste potion. So we'll just be careful not to run too fast. I can think we can even put in one more like that. Yeah, I don't know if you ever need to go this fast, because it's hard to maneuver, and down on Earth is mostly annoying. So, but one is okay. Space boots with the padded landing boots. If we go up in the air and then we fall down, I don't get any damage at all. I don't know if it's an upper limit, but maybe this is quite high. So that's quite convenient. And let's see, let's take the helmet first. No, let's take the chest. Here you put the jetpack. You've already seen it. And there are two button hotkeys that you need to press. So if you take a look up here, this is a chest piece, and these are the upgrades you have installed. If I just press X, I think that's a standard key. I will switch it from on, like now, to off. And if I am, I think it's, yeah, when I'm in on mode, I actually don't need to. Shift X means hover mode, like this. So quite close to the creative flight, go up, go down. So that can be quite useful when building your base, for example. And then Shift X again, and X to turn it off completely. But it runs on hydrogen. So let's go there soon. What more do we have here? So that means that you need hydrogen tanks, and you put them here. So if we just clear everything out, then you can see we have two slots for oxygen. Where is it? Hydrogen, jetpack, something like this. And oxygen needs to be refilled, as well as hydrogen. Oxygen is not needed here on Earth, but it will be on the moon. So let's go and fill this up. You can see the two bars for O2 and H2. And as I mentioned last time, you can refill them in these gauss charge pads. Either you just remove the pressure tanks and fill them manually, but you can also step because you have this slot in here. but you can also step on it. This is the oxygen, and you can see that it's slowly refilling. I think it went faster last time, but it is refilling very slowly. And that means that we are getting our oxygen in place. And here is where we have the hydrogen, and it will also refill. I can't see it in without the suit workstation. But as you can see now, this is totally refilled, and well, we got halfway. Like that. And then it will start to refill the other one as well. And we can place, let's see, high pressure. We can have more of these here. And remember to bring it. Hydrogen shows full, but it shouldn't, I think. Yeah, now it updated. So now it's almost full again. So that's how we refill it. Let's see, 7,200, this is empty. So I guess it's not updating perfectly, but you can bring a suit workstation. It's good. Just remember that if you take your space suit parts off when you are up in space, you will get damage. So perhaps we do that in a safe environment. So let's finally take a look at the space helmet. Here I have all the upgrades. Anti-fog, it can be there. I don't think we have any fog on the moon, but the hover upgrade is required if you want to do hover with the jetpack. You can skip it, of course, but then you can't hover, and I think it's totally worth it. Atmosphere analyzer, we'll see that when we get to space. Here in the lower left corner, breathable, yes, and the atmosphere type. It will be different when we get to the moon. And so let's skip these just for now and place a few flight speed controllers. And then let's go up. This is how fast I can fly with the three flight speed upgrades. And then if we remove it, well, noticeable difference. But you can't have all the upgrades, so I'll just turn it off. So let's go in here, and depending on what you need to do, of course, beacon, atmosphere, and one of these perhaps. So I think that's pretty much what we should look at. Let's take a look at the beacon, because it's up on the moon over there. Easily crafted like the other one. It's also a multi-block structure in the Holo-Projector. Well, let's see. Beacon, this is the one. So machine structures, machine structure, structure, and a block of redstone up in the top. So it's not too bad to craft. Coils, circuit, stuff like that. So let's go to the moon. Right, I'll see you up there. This is actually for the next episode, but let's have a sneak peek. And the rocket took us to the moon. So now we're here and everything is totally fine. You can see we have oxygen, hydrogen, but now the oxygen is actually being used up. So keep an eye on this one if it goes down too low. So actually I just wanted to show how the beacon looks. So when you built it, it looks like this, and we can turn it on. Very neat. And you can see that in the top corner or top of the screen, there's an arrow, a blue arrow. And if I just run away, far, far, far away, the beacon will help me to find my way back. So this is one way to do it. If you don't have any map, well, it actually has one more function, and it is to you can put it on a planet if you're on a server, and then you have other people on the server, and they haven't discovered this planet. Moon is available for everyone, as far as I know, but there are other planets, and if they haven't discovered them, you can put the beacon on the planet, and then they can locate it. So that's useful on a server, but if you're alone, then you probably will only use it for this purpose, for the beacon. So let's turn it off. All right, so I think that's pretty much it for this video. If we take a look in the suit workstation, now we'll get damaged. So if we just remove things, yep, this is bad, and you can see we have, yeah, at least I can check my status, but it's dangerous. All right, in next episode, I will actually go through how to get here. So I hope I see you then. Take care, and bye-bye.